Let me proceed the lecture. For the semiconductors, from the name itself we can identify it is a semi, partially conducting. So we observe that the conductivity lies between 10 power minus 3 to 10 power minus 8 ohm per centimeter. So what is ohm is that? It resists. So you know very well, if you have copper wire, the electrons are flowing throughout the copper wire and you observe it is a very good conductor being copper. At the same time, semiconductor, you are able to conduct only partially, which means what? Partially it will not conduct. That is what? Partially it is trying to resist. Resist means what? You say it is critical. Okay, you avoid. So it is measured in terms of ohm per centimeter. Okay, so what is the range of conductivity? It is only 10 power minus 3 to 10 power minus 8 ohm per centimeter. So that much of conductivity will be there. Remaining it will not conduct. So what happens? It will be remaining ideal. Okay, ideal means complete, tomorrow. Okay, so what we need to do is that, so as you are idle, I need to push something, what you call it as a voltage. Okay, unless the running force is not provided, it will be idle. That is called as a semiconductor. So now you are in the state of a semiconducting action in which you will be into idle state. Okay, something, some portions will be conducted. Unless or until I am not providing force enough, it could not able to conduct the electricity or the voltage or the current respectively. So you see here review of the intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductor. So it is a recollect of your chemistry, what you have studied all about the intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductors. So the name itself indicates that intrinsics, inside itself. Semiconductor itself having a purely chemical substances. So what is semiconductor? Partially conducts. A component will be there. So some chemical substance will be there. If you consider the chemical substance, so it comprises of some chemical components. That chemical components will be of intrinsic in nature. What is intrinsic? It is available inside itself. Purely chemical. Okay. And what is extrinsic is that? So it will be purely chemical. We need to enhance its performance in the sense we will be adding impurities. That is called as a doping. Already you have studied everything in your chemistry. It's a recall to your intrinsic, extrinsic. What is the valence shell? What is the conduction band? What is the energy band gap? Everything you have studied in physics and chemistry about that's all chemical reactions. But still, recalling onto those concepts, we have a review of. It's a review. It's not a origin to explain. We are recalling and making a review of intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductor devices. So we have the types of semiconductors identified referred to be a silicon, germanium, gallium, arsenide. Okay, GALLIUMARSENIDE, gallium arsenide. So we talk about this germanium, silicon, gallium arsenide, which is called as a semiconductors. That has a few electrons, only few number of electrons and not plenty electrons. If you consider a component, the component has only few electrons. The remaining will not connect. Okay. So what happens is that it could able to identify, you will be having a crystalline appearance or a crystalline structure or a crystalline pattern, what is called to be a crystal lattice. Now we have the electrons. We have the electrons, we have the protons, we have the neutrons.